Hi, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Hope you're enjoying your Monday. Today is May 16th, 2022. There was a magnitude 5.4 earthquake along the Kryl-Kamchatka Trench. I'm probably pronouncing it wrong. This was a very deep earthquake and is caused by the subduction of the Pacific Plate. Let me bring it out. Up over here, we got the Aleutian Islands. And we'll go back to the location of that earthquake. And this earthquake was 95 kilometers in depth, which is about 59 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. It was given an intensity level of 5, but then over here on the shake map, they gave it an intensity level of 4. Here it shows intensity level 5. Only one person reportedly said they felt this earthquake. So if it was 4, it would have been felt indoors by many and outdoors by a few. And if it was nighttime, you would have been woken up. Now, if it was an intensity level 5, means that everybody felt it. And there would have been some breakage. Dishes, maybe windows broke, plaster, and tall objects probably would have been knocked over. Being so deep, it's an indication of the Pacific Plate temporarily got locked and suddenly decided to move. And then over here, we have a volcano, which is Abeko. Back in, on February 6th, I believe, of this year, there was a hydrothermal explosion there. Weather Sarbo posted a video, you can watch it, of this hydrothermal eruption. It made the news about 2 days later. So zooming in using Google Earth, yeah, I don't know where here on this volcano that it happened. But also interestingly, along the trench, let me bring it out, there's been some very large earthquakes in the past. Back in 1737, a magnitude 9.3. And in 1952, a 9.0. Some of the notes I have here, it says many strong megathrust earthquakes occur here. Some of them among the largest in the world. November 15, 2006, an 8.3 earthquake occurred near Kryl Islands. And September 26, 2003, an 8.3, and also there was a 9.0. I'll give you a link to this page. Thrust earthquakes are the worst. They often cause tsunamis. I don't know if these cause tsunamis, but anyways, it's close to that location and shows you it was stuck and then it popped and yeah, maybe relieve pressure so that more subduction could easier flow or go under. And maybe have a larger one sometime down the road. I'm not going to ask if any of you felt this earthquake. It is a very remote location, but it's been a while since I covered anything over here. So I thought I would do that. I hope you enjoyed it, and thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for your support. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, yeah, please put those down below. Please take care, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.